and her disciples on a variety of spiritual topics. Today, we are blessed to present this insightful conference entitled Wake Up and Be Vegan in This Time of Cleaning, Part 5 of 6, on Between Master and Disciples, given in English on June 26, 2020.
We still have a lot of earth, you know, even though crowded.
Yes.
Oh, we'll be 9 billion or something. We are 7 billion now, right?
Yes, Master.
Even 7 billion, but we still have a lot of room everywhere, you know?
Yes, Master.
Even Taiwan. If you have some time to go to Taiwan and then you go out on many different roads and even on the highway, you will see many empty mountain forest is still there. Yeah.
Yes, Master.
Oh, of course, it belongs to the government, and you can't just go there and leave at random. You can't just bring a tent there and say, "Oh, it's no man land." But if they come up and legally, they can just live anywhere. There's still many room left. Yeah.
Yes.
Even Hong Kong, believe it or not, they still have mountains and forests.
Yes, Master.
Untouched. Because sometime I was thinking of buying land in Hong Kong for disciples to meditate. Because the present center is very small. No? For Hong Kong, good enough, but not for everybody, for international. Huh?
Yes, Master.
And they want me to stay there. And I also like Hong Kong very much at that time. At that time, to me, Hong Kong is very free, very advanced in many aspects. And the Hong Kong people are very nice.
Yes.
The one I met, yeah?
Yes, Master.
I thought maybe it's good to be there, yeah? And then, but I cannot find any suitable place. Yeah. But even then, Hong Kong had big places, you know, but not big enough. Big like for 2,000, 3,000, 5,000 people. But we are exceeding that, yeah?
Yes.
So
yes.
Even though for Hong Kong it's very big, but it's not suitable, huh? For retreat and all that sometimes.
Yes, Master.
But I did get some more new land for Hong Kong people.
Oh, wow.
I think they buy one piece or two for themselves, and other pieces I buy.
Yeah.
Oh. And renovate my little hut and all that. Even Hong Kong and Taiwan have a lot of free land left. In the earth, we have a lot of land left. Yeah?
Yes.
Like maybe... If you want to own a big land, you can go to Siberia, for example. Maybe with $50,000, you can buy many, many hectares. Nah?
Yes, yes, Master.
Yeah, all for yourself. Wouldn't that be nice? Freedom. Hmm?
Yes.
Space, no neighbors. Yeah. No spying. The dogs can run forever. Hmm? We don't have to leash them. They'll be too tired to run anymore, anywhere. So probably just drop somewhere and we just go pick them back up. Pick them up and bring them back. That will be freedom, huh?
Yes, Master.
Also in Mongolia, they have a big Gobi Desert. Gobi Desert, eh?
Yes. Yes, Master.
People live there, you know, in some area there are water. Yeah. So they live in there. So if we are... not convenient or comfortable, we can all go there. Yeah, this they'll be welcoming us, yeah? Desert people are very generous, you know?
Yes.
In their house, they always leave some food and drink for anyone who come in. Their house never locked.
Wow.
Always leave some food and drink enough for a few days for the travelers, whoever pass by their house, if they need them. But most people, they're very honest. They also bring their own food. Just that if they need it, they can. You see, they can stay in their house, eat their food, sleep on their bed, drink their water, wow. However precious it is. They leave it open for travelers. How nice, huh?
That's very nice.
If the whole world do that, if the whole world learn from that, wouldn't that be wonderful?
Yes.
Yeah, instead of throwing food away, why don't give to the poor?
Yes.
Throwing food away is so that to keep the price high.
Oh, I understand.
Many times, many farmers, many producers of fruits, vegetables, they throw them away. Even though they can give it to the poor, give it to food bank or whatever. Our world still have a lot of work to do. So you guys hang on in there, okay?
Yes, yes Master.
Just hang yourself. Not hang yourself, but hang yourself on SMTV work.
We're with you, Master.
Yeah. Stabilize yourself there. Don't think of going anywhere. Doing what? Huh? And you see the world chaotic outside? Huh?
Yes, Master.
Even if you go out, can you even find a job or can you even find your life, your guarantee, your insurance?
No,
insurance is only money, life. Nobody can insure you.
Right,
yes.
Yeah, life is so impermanent, so unpredictable. Nobody expect this COVID-19 came, show up at your door like that.
No, nobody did.
We've been talking about it, warning about it, but nobody can. Ah, God. Why don't just change, you know, just change all into organic farming, give subsidized money to these meat industry people, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, and then they change their life. If they have money from government, they would change, yeah?
Yes.
Then they start new life. Why wait until everybody's sick and then cannot work and no income? And have to pay for everybody like this and make the country bankrupt.
Yes, Master.
And don't know if can even get up again.
Yes, Master.
I read some news or some headline that said that COVID-19 has brought this country to its knees.
Correct, Master.
Really prostrate some country.
Yes, Master.
Making debt more and more and people life cannot even save. Why wait for this to happen? Why? Why, if not already, disease are caused all by animals, at least 75%, yeah?
Yes, Master.
The rest are, I think, hereditary. But also because the ancestor or the parents or the grandparents are eating meat, that's why their system are weak.
Right. Yes.
Yes.
And then the disease is there and then it stay in the family. If they have been living with clean, vegan diet, at least even vegetarian diet, it wouldn't have been so bad, no? They wouldn't have even disease to pass on to their poor, precious children, yeah? Because in Vietnam we say, if the parents eat too salty food, then the children will be thirsty.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, just like we say, we have the ancestor sin passed on to the children, the next generation,
yes,
huh?
Yes,
that's what they say. Every country, they have similar saying, I think.
Yes, Master.
What did they say in America?
They say something like, the sins of our ancestors we have to pay for. It's similar to what you said already, Master.
Mm. We have the such saying too.
What did they say?
祖宗罪家里担, means the grandfather's sin will pass down to the grandson, etc.
Ah, the grandfather's sin will pass down to the children.
Oh. Yes, yes.
That is very spiritual, is another thing. In our lab, we also say something like, if somebody do something bad, okay, or treat somebody badly, and that victim would say to the aggressor, saying, oh, please, think about it. Leave some merit to your children, won't you?
Mm-hmm.
It's something like that, okay?
Yes. Yeah.
Like, stop making trouble because your children will inherit your bad karma. That's what I mean, yeah? Awesome.
Yes. Yes.
Not just eating salty food. It's similar meaning anyway.
Yes. Mm. Yes.
Okay. So, what else? I see my diary. Anything else I talked to you about? Yeah, that's about the thing. About the light, the northern light. Oh, on the 14th, Sunday, the spider came again.
Oh.
They surrounding me all the time now. They come anytime, surprise me. I say, hey, buddy, what? I call them buddies, yeah?
Yes,
what? So he said to me, quotation mark, bow to you, end quote. So I say, what for? Can you even bow? I don't know if I said it to your sister already or not. Maybe I did, no? You don't know how the conference has not came out yet, huh?
It hasn't aired yet, Master.
Oh, you know what? I just want to say hello to you, actually. And to ask whether or not you okay, if anything you need. Oh, and I wanted to tell you something before I forgot. I wanted to call you to tell you that if you have fan, you know, don't blow it directly on your face all the time, yeah? Christmas. Maybe for some minutes and you cool down and then you direct it in another part of the body or sideways, okay?
Yes, Master.
If it's cool enough already, don't direct it on your body because the dust from your room or your place will blow into your nose, yeah?
Yes,
sometimes it carries something not favorable if you don't clean it every day, knowing you guys, men. Yeah?
I understand, Master.
Because I just saw in some news, they say that it could make you sick, you know?
Yes, Master.
Dry your skin, see, oh, that you don't like it. You want to stay handsome, see. And they say also make your sore throat, yeah?
Yes, Master.
And cough. Sometimes if you cough during the night, for some reason, can you hear me?
Yes,
still?
Master.
Okay, good. I have two phones here, imagine. One phone is to record my beautiful old face, and another phone is to hear you.
Yes, Master.
Yeah.
It's the much mobile now, Master.
Yeah, the mobile phone, that's how I can hear you because the landline don't work. Yeah, yeah. I am a very low-tech people. I don't care. We have spontaneous meetings sometimes. It's better than too much preparing, okay?
Yes, Master.
Too much preparing, I lost it, you see?
Yes, Master.
I lost my loving feeling,
yes,
my patience, my inspiration, whatever, yeah?
Yes, Master.
We are not machine, you know?
Yes, Master.
It's always official or professional. If I say I'm professional all the time or in all these decades, every time in front of thousands or hundreds of people already, yeah?
Yes, Master.
So when I talk to my own family members, I don't need to always be so long preparing or waiting for professional equipment and all that. Who cares, yeah?
Yes, Master.
I'm old already. Let's face it, no matter how much touch up, don't look younger. Don't look too much younger, yeah?
You still look good, Master.
People love me anyway.
Yes, Master.
Who cares what I look like?
Yes, Master. We love you.
I'm confident people love me.
Yeah, we do, Master. Everyone does.
Self-esteem, huh? Very high. Yeah, I have proof for it. Yeah. Because I have proven my personal experience. See my dog, do they look like me? No. Do they look like a handsome guy or anything? No. I love them so much.
Yes, Master.
The dogs, they don't look anything like we imagine. They don't look like us, no? Mm.
No,
ah, some do, some do. Some do look like the owners, but not all the dogs that look like me, no? Even if they do or not, I still love them so much.
Yes,
yeah, you know that. I sometimes get on well with some humans, caretaker of the dogs, because I love them so much. I love the dogs so much. I worry they do this not right, do that not right. Understand?
Yes, Master.
And fall off sometimes is not very good for me. That people might think I treat dogs better than them. It's not true. I just more protective because they like children, you know?
Yes, Master.
They are very dependent on us because we bring them into our home and they live according to our rules now. They cannot be outside and be free and take care of themselves.
Yes, Master.
So we have to take good care of them. And I think I know how, that's all. That's why I tell some people should do this, to do that. Like it's summer, you trim the hair, you know, even we have aircon, but better trim the hair, huh?
Yes, Master.
So when they go out walking, they don't get out of breath. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, Master.
And drool all over the planet like that. Yeah. Because of some of their tongue, they have to let it out, you know, the drool come out so that it cool off, yeah?
Yes, Master.
But for that, sometimes, you know, people don't like to be told off. I feel sorry also. Sometimes I apologize. Sometimes I don't. Because I know I'm right.
Yes, yes.
But even then, nobody likes to be told that they're wrong. Yeah, I know that. It hurts the ego, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because of the dogs. Not because of any treasure or money or job or competition for beauty or anything. that I make a, you know, a rip with people.
Yes, Master.
Never mind. So I asked him, what for? Why did I say to? Yeah. Oh, because I cut off this to tell you about the fan, huh?
Yes, Master.
It's true. If I have fan at night because I want to save aircon sometime, then I put the fan next to me on my face to cool off, then I cough. And my soul very dry, you know, almost sore in the morning. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you wake up at night and cough, a few cough, you drink three very little sip of water, okay?
Yes, Master.
Always put water next to you, clean water, and you drink just three little sip, not big drink.
Yes, Master.
That's the cure. I hope I tell you, and then I I still can keep it. Every time I tell you something later, I don't have it. I don't worry. I have other stuff. Maybe it works.